Okay, we can go live.
Hello and a very warm welcome to everyone who has tuned in to this interaction. It's great to see people from all parts of the world log in. A special welcome to all our COVID warriors, doctors, healthcare workers, and all those who have been relentless in the fight against COVID. Before I move further in this webinar, I want to talk a little bit about this series and about Dr. Reddy's Laboratories. We are a global pharmaceutical company committed to ensuring affordable and accessible medicines around the world. In these COVID times, in addition to ensuring uninterrupted supplies of medicine, we have been facilitating a series of interactions with leaders and trailblazers from different fields. The goal of these interactions is to draw inspiration from these extraordinary people and to learn from their stories. My name is Deepak Sapra, and I will be your host for today. For today's interaction, it's my honor and it's my privilege to introduce this extraordinary person. A person who possibly now needs no introduction. The only boxer in the world, male or female, to win 8 world championship medals. The only woman to be the world amateur boxing champion for a record 6 times. And the only woman boxer to have won a medal in each of the first 7 world championships. Starting from a very humble background, with very limited resources at her disposal, in the true spirit of a fighter, she overcame all hurdles to become a trailblazer in a sport that has been traditionally a male domain. The medal for India in the 2012 London Olympic Games in the flyweight 51 kg category, winning the world championships, being ranked the world number one women's light flyweight boxer by AIBA have been some of her many crowning achievements in the ring. Outside the ring, she has been honored with the Padma Vibhushan, India's second largest civilian honor, and was nominated to the Indian Parliament as a person of great eminence in 2016. All the glory of the past several years has further intensified her commitment and her desire to go for gold at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, which are now rescheduled to 2021. Besides the roles that she plays in public life, both inside the ring and outside the ring, at home, she's a doting mother of 4 adorable children, 3 sons and a little daughter, twins Rechungwar and Kupenwar, Prince and daughter Marilyn. She lives with her loving and supporting husband Onler and a very supportive extended family. Please join me in welcoming this extraordinary inspiration, champion, super mom, Mangte Chung Neijang, Mary Kom. Welcome, Mary. It's a great honor to have you with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.
So Mary, let me begin with a question, and so many people have been asking this question. Tell us how your journey as a boxer started. What happened? What really inspired you to get here? So we would all want to hear the early days and how this journey started.
Well, it was so interesting, of course. My life journey was initially, it was so difficult, it was so tough. Becoming from humble background, there is no any sources. You have already mentioned, becoming from humble background, no sources. And of course, that was, you know, I was fighting against, like, might be only few people have that. Nobody have that kind of fighting spirits. I have a lot of courage, and you know, there is so many things going in my family, because my parents are not unable to, you know, support me. First, even in the education. But instead, there are so many obstacles, and I have fought many challenges in my life. That was the beginning. What I have choose boxing in the first time, yes, as a, you know, a child, or I was very fond of to play any games, not only single games, not only boxing. Even boxing is, I, when I grew up only, I you know, really this I really know that what is the exactly what is this game. Mm-hmm. I haven't know that boxing is a part of game. Mm-hmm. I have started in my school to take up a sports. Mm-hmm. And I represent all the games and sports. Mm-hmm. Participate, and even I win all the you know, which is the games in the schools. I don't know how I will explain to you. I'm really fond of to play sports, and many people, mostly my teachers, are very supportive. They always motivating me, and you know, keep pushing me. Yes, you will be a champion, you know, in the future. This is always giving the message to me. Keep hammering in my ear, actually, all the time. So, what I know, there is so many restrictions in my family as well, because they could not able to support me in both field, actually, schooling and sports. Becoming from humble background, I think for us, like, you know, for me is very difficult, very tough. My parents were not able to give all the needs, financially especially. Even when I took up boxing, was I doesn't, you know, I doesn't tell to my family as well. I was hiding, and I start doing boxing. That is very interesting, actually. I have started first as an athlete, and secondly, athletic is also very suitable for me. I can take up any sports, running, jumping, throwing, any type of game. I'm very suitable. I can do whatever. I'm very unique person. I think honestly, I'm, you know, I can do all the sports. I can play all the sports. I'm very flexible as well. Even I already grew up like I was, I think, 16, 17 years old when I started, when I, practically, you know, in the field, in the ground. So that was a journey when I started. And secondly is boxing. While I'm going for the training, for the practice, first athletic, I step up first in athletic. So while I'm going in the practice, I saw some guys are, you know, doing training, state of boxing, and some kind of sparring also. Then I was so inspiring. And I already heard about the legend Muhammad Ali. Mm-hmm. He is my inspiration. He is my heroes. And I really inspired by him. And there are so many other legends also, like Tyson and Manny Pacquiao. There are so many other legends also, etc., etc. So I really inspired by them. And I just want to mention a little bit my childhood. You know, in my village, actually, there are so many people, they are looked down, most of the girl child. They are not able to go out and play, you know, openly. And most of the guys, I mean, boys are come out and playing, they are frequently doing, and there is no any, you know, there is any problem at all, no restriction at all, but girls are some restriction, like, you know, stay home and help your parents, whatever, you know, whatever they are doing. So even I'm not doing, I help parents also in this time to time. Mm-hmm. And of course, sometimes I also feel, you know, like, you know, I just want to go out and, you know, look around also and participate. Yes, I request them. I always request, and sometimes they allow me, sometimes they are not allowed me. Mm-hmm. They are playing football. So they say that this is not a woman game. Forget about the boxing. When I took a boxing, was terrible. People are talking all the time negative. Mm-hmm. There is no any positive at all. No motivation. And from the village, I have lot of, you know, I was suffering, like, you know, looking down all the time. And that is the fault. If men can do, why women can't? If other, what I was, you know, thinking, it's come in my mind is, you know, if men can do, women also. Mm-hmm. Women also can do whatever they want. Whatever I want, I will do it. And that is my commitment. Yes, I'm not telling, you know, openly. Yes, I keep already in my mind, one day I will show you. This is my commitment. And I took a boxing, then is, oh my God, so bad situation, the atmosphere. And in the society, of course, and you know, even influence to my parents also, like my father's relative as well as my mom relative, why you put in this game? Mm-hmm. Make her a good education, mm-hmm. not the boxing. Boxing is only for a man game. This is not a woman game. What she will, get in her life. She will not get anything. If she got injured, then your responsibility as well as financially short, how you will do that? There is so many influence from the other side to my parents, to my mom and dad. And yes, even that's why I hide it, you know. I'm really afraid to tell them that, you know, I took a boxing first. Yes, they already know that I took a sports athletic first, and second, I left athletic and I took a boxing second time, and that is my final decision. Yes, I can, I have a potential in sports, and of course, boxing is going to be a newly introduced. It's not introduced at all when I started. It's on the way only. On the way only.
Right.
Women boxing, actually, men is already very much popular, and there are so many boxers also. There are so many boxers already winning a medal in international level as well. From Manipur also, there are so many boxers already winning in international level. And boxing is not introducing at all. It was introduced in 2000 only. So I felt that, you know, yes, this is also the newly game. And if I give a lot of effort, or if I train very hard, then that will be very, very, you know, suitable for me. Easily from the beginning only, I can have the experience in the future, the national level, also in international and other highest international level, like Olympic Games. You know, so that is what I believe. And newly game is a little bit initially was, you know, easy to win any medal.
Right.
And already some of the games, like, you know, already many years competing, and there is very competitive. I mean, this is the fact, you know. I just want to share about my journey, and of course, slowly, I take up. I was very lucky that I am very different. I was learned very quickly. During 6 months, I was a state champion, and during 1 year, a national champion as well as international medalist, meaning, wow. That is the journey. First I have, you know, firstly I have quickly and winning all the medals in 1 year.
Wow.
And yeah, so I think God is very kind to all of us. Very kind to all of us. And I am so lucky, don't be sad. I mean, don't be sigh, or don't feel bad also. I was so lucky. You know, God is so kind for me. And there is a lot of challenging in my life. That is the first challenge. And the second challenge is, again, before marriage and after marriage. Think about before marriage, there's so many having obstacles, you know. There are so many problems facing. And I was already already like, you know, win a world champion. And one gold, one silver. And I got married and in 2005. And of course, there are many people, you know, around, like, you know, waiting for talk negative.
Mm-hmm.
Before also, before marriage and people are all the time, you know, talking about on me only, or I don't know, to other also. I don't know exactly. But what I heard that is they are talking a lot in my profession. And of course, marriage. And again, I prove myself. Already proved before marriage, and I prove after the marriage also, two-time world champion. And after I have a children, I have a kids, and that is again challenging, you know, double challenging for me. It's double, it's triple, it's come by, you know, step by step, it's come step by step. And again, I prove myself after having a baby. First, I have a, you know, twins. It was so terrible, so difficult. And God make them grow. And, you know, now already they are a big boy. They're already 13 years when they are very small, when there was baby, you know, so difficult. I can't express my, you know, express also. It was so difficult, and people are crazy. I don't know why they are doing this, you know, adjustment to other also. Why they are not doing in their own family?
So Mary, when this happened, when so many people started coming up with so many things, and you had a family to take care of, you had very small children. So how did you keep your focus? How did you keep your commitment to boxing in the midst of all these distractions and all this negativity?
Yes, that's why I was sometimes I'm very straight. Yes, yes, no, no. A kind of person. I'm not, you know, I'm not a lie to anyone. And I'm always doing, you know, clean. I'm doing everything is cleanly.
Mm-hmm.
When I did my work and giving me some responsibility, should be perfect. Not here and there. That's why I'm telling you very cleanly, I'm doing in my profession as well as at home also. I help, you know, my parents every time, every step. So, and people are crazy, like, you know, they are doing a judgment to other also. So I feel sometimes, you know, when I heard in newspaper or something like in the social media, I feel like, you know, so feel very bad. And what I did wrong, there is something I done wrong. That is, again, I realized that, you know, if I did something wrong, then I will apology, you know. So I will say sorry. Yes, forgive me. Next time I won't do. Next time I will not do. This, there is no any, I'm not doing any wrong thing or bad or something, like, you know. So I was sometimes so, even distraction also, mind, mentally, physically also. But forget about all the happen. I don't want to remind again, but I'm just sharing a little bit the challenging. I have already done 5-time challenge. I took a challenge.
Yes, Mary.
I accept 5 times. First, I'm telling you, first time before marriage, I proved myself as a girl, as a woman. Okay. And the second time after I got married, again, I proved myself. And third time after a mother, again, I prove it. And again, there is Olympic coming up, and there are so many things coming up, like women boxing was not in the world championship also those days, and it's slowly it's introduced in international level, in the high level also. So the fourth challenge is my category is not there.
Yes.
I was fought in 48 category, and there is no 48 degree. It started in the smallest category is 51 category.
51.
Mm. Yeah. And that is the only option I have. And there is three category they already include in the Olympic. First category is 51 and 60 and 75.
Mm.
And I cannot able to go to 60 category and 75.
Right.
51 is the the smallest category I can able to do that. And I jump up and people are talking like, you know, Mary is so small, so short, and could not able to win in the Olympic, could not be able to qualify. So many people are, you know, minds already is I'm not saying all the people, I'm saying some people.
Right. So Mary, now all that
educated, or I don't know what really happened in to them, but forget, I already proved myself. And now what happened? The 5 challenges, what happened now? Already age over. It's gone. Yes.
Yes. And now, Mary, the other thing.
The only number. I'm telling you, it's the only number. Okay.
Yes. And now, Mary, this Tokyo Olympics are coming up. So everybody's really looking forward to the Tokyo Olympics. And you qualified just before the games were postponed.
Yes.
And what I want to understand from you is that now we are all in the midst of a very difficult COVID situation with the lockdown and everything being very different from what it was earlier. So what is your routine now? How are you preparing for the Tokyo Olympics? How are you keeping yourself motivated? And boxing is a contact sport. So how are you finding a partner to spar? So just tell us a little bit about your Tokyo preparations and how are you keeping yourself focused and motivated on it?
Well, it was not only to me, it was to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
Lockdown is lockdown. I don't want to contact, to outside people. For even my family also, if they coming from Manipur, quarantine, of course, or done your COVID test, then we can meet. This is happened because, I love my family. Life is very important to all of us, not only for me. I'm very, other is secondary. Earning or going out and do whatever you want, that is secondary.
Mm-hmm.
Life is now in this situation, in this pandemic situation, who will not scare that?
Yeah.
Who is not scared in this situation? there are so many people, you know, die. They lose their life. Forgive it, only not 10, 20, 30, 40. How many people are die? Really, in this situation, yes, there are so many people are also having the same. And what I just want to say about my experience during lockdown is, yes, I stay at home and stay home, work from home. Yes, even I could not able to do my sparring. You know, sparring is one of the most important for boxing. Contact sport is, you know, other activities, strengthening and like you know, other activities, shadow boxing for endurance and all, stamina, for stamina, there is we can do anywhere. If you not go out, maybe if you not go in the field also, you can do, you can done your workout at home.
Mm-hmm.
But sparring is it's very risky. If someone call you know, my sparring partner, or that will be, I don't want to take the risks.
Absolutely.
If anything happen, my sparring partner or to me, and for me and my sparring partner, forget it. And I have a small children at home. I was very much, you know, care about them. If they are happen, if anything happened to them, that will be very difficult.
Sure. So are you keeping yourself in good shape through exercise and diet? What are the things that you're doing currently?
I'm doing at home all my works, training regularly. Mm-hmm. I'm not you know, doing outside at all, because in this situation I don't want to have, you know, any happen. And my diet, yes, we purchase outside, yes, proper, or you know, all the norms like government has given us to follow for safety, wear masks, and you know, full cover, like, you know, for safety, use sanitize hand wash, everything. And now we are still safe, we are following all the rule and this thing,
right,
government rules.
Yes, and absolutely,
yeah, maybe. So outside purchase, and only we are, I'm having a good food at home, not outside food.
Okay.
That is my diet. Sometimes vegetables, sometimes mostly frequently we have vegetarians, like you know, green leaf.
Mm-hmm.
So the non-veg, actually yes, I'm non-veg eater, but not frequently, sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So this is my diet, and I work at home. I don't want to come down my, you know, like energy, my stamina. Mm-hmm. Yeah, when everything is done, you know, everything is over, like COVID over, then I have start again. It will not take so long, it will take only one week, 2 weeks.
Right.
No sparring. I have already experienced. I have fighting 20 years all now. 20 years. So that contact sports for me, yes, initially must be very difficult for me. You know, again, you know, everything we have to, you know, apply in the ring. you know, implement must be what exactly I want to throw punches could not be connect, should maybe it won't connect or something like, you know. But one week will be difficult, but after then I will handle very easy. I will be handling very easily.
That's great, Mary. And you know, 1.4 billion people are going to be cheering for you, so I'm sure that will give that extra energy.
Thank you.
So as we look at this situation, Mary, I think each of us are in our own battle in the pandemic situation. There are also some members of the community who are at the forefront of this COVID battle. And these people are showing extraordinary commitment. So for example, doctors, nurses, pharmacists, pharmaceutical warriors who are manufacturing medicines, professional representatives who are going to doctors, making sure medicines are available. So they are all fighters in their own way. They're fighting in this current situation, which is quite unprecedented. So what would be the message that you would want to give to these people? I would say these people are our heroes today, our corona warriors. So what message would you want to give to them?
Absolutely. Even I also, you know, wants to give this message. Maybe they have already got many messages from others also in the social media, because this situation we could not able to go and, you know, give the this good you know, appreciation. I mean, could not able to say appreciation to them, but honestly, I will speak from my bottom of my heart. I salute and respect. They are my real heroes for me. Even not only for me as well, for the country. Frontline workers and of course, making days and night selflessly, I should say, selflessly giving their best for treatment for those who are sick. Mm-hmm. Especially, of course, to doctor, nurses, and other staff. I just want to say, let's continue to do the good work to serve our society in the best way we can. Mm-hmm. We are fighting a war of health. And yes, I give respect to them, and I, of course, I salute to them. They are my real heroes, and they are my second God. God is God, right? God is God, and they are my second God. If doctors, nurses, and the others, frontline worker, whoever, even the police from the government side, there are so many people that come out from the family, sacrifice their life. And I give, you know, whoever lost their life, I give my condolence to them also. Of course, they are fighting for us, they are fighting for the country, and I don't know what to say. It was so painful when we remember those days again. This that is, I mean, still, this is not over. COVID-19 is not over yet, and there's so many people are suffering. And even our doctor and nurses are still there for them to, you know, to save their life. They're trying to save their life. How much they are giving up for day and night. They are eating or not eating, we don't know.
Right.
And they're having a race. I mean, for a few seconds, are they sitting or not sitting? We don't know. We are so lucky. I'm still at home, and I'm still, my parents, my family are still at home. No need to worry. Like, you know, if we are staying at home, it's no need to worry.
Right.
For them, it's so risky.
Yes.
Sacrifice their life. For who? Why are they doing? This is only for us, no?
Yes.
So I really, they are my heroes. And I always, you know, have that respect and love to them. I give all my love whoever done for us. And one thing only I just want to mention, that is, there will be so many like from the others might be not getting they don't get appreciation also, might be so much fighting for us also, you know, might be 50-50. Like some of the doctors, some of the nurses have appreciation, or other front lines also have their appreciation, but some of them are not having that kind of appreciation also.
Yes.
As
you were speaking, and what you mentioned is absolutely a very, 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 very important point. As you were speaking, of course, a lot of people sent messages to me right now. And these are especially doctors and healthcare workers, especially women healthcare workers and doctors who have just sent me some messages. I will read out one or two for you, and I will, you know, they want you to respond to this. So Dr. Amrita Durge from Thane, Dr. Rashmita Naik from Bhubaneswar, Dr. Vijeta Singh from Gwalior. I think they broadly, I think the theme of the question is that you are balancing home, boxing, and parliament, and in a situation like this. So what is your advice to others like them who are managing both home and profession? And do you think this question is only specific to women achievers? So what message would you like to give to them? And that's something they would like to know from you.
Thank you. Only I just want to give a message to all the frontline workers, especially women. I really understand. And being a girl, being a woman, being a mother, and there might be many responsibility at home as well as your on your field.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Even I also doing the same. I have another responsibility, like parliamentary.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I just want to share might be, I have already shared or give a statement or not, I really don't understand. But today I just want to share you, that is the last world championship. It was in our country only in 2008 world championship. what happened? I have no time to race. Mm-hmm. Parliament session is going. World Championships is next month. Mm-hmm. And that Parliament session was also very important. There are some bills going to, you know, pass. Mm-hmm. Of course, I'm so glad that, you know, BJP government has nominated me. Of course, I will do something for, you know, government. Like, you know, for me, what I was thinking is I'm not a politician at all. And I'm very straight. I don't, I'm not a political, you know, my story is not, my journey is not in a political line. Mm-hmm. And government has nominated me, and it was an honor for me, mm-hmm. To serve for the nation. Whatever I can, you know, a good for the nation, I will always support for them. And I do that. I was running to parliament in the morning. Oh, sorry. First, I was running to my practice stadium, come back. And it was so early, 6 to 9. Or 6 to 8, come back soon and shower. Even I don't have time to, you know, have breakfast or lunch or something. Run to parliament and come back and have quickly again, have something and have some rest and evening training. Prepare for the evening training. So difficult. Oh my God, there is no time to rest for me. No recovery time. Even I have a small children at home. They are always, you know, come to me. They come to me. They need me, I know. But they don't know what I'm running here, running around. And I have the small baby, including at night time again, I have to feed, wake up three times, sometimes two times, sometimes three times, sometimes four times. So hard. But honestly, I did everything. Because if you want to go up higher, if he really wants to do something, first for our family, for next, for the society and for the country, then you have to fight. There will be so many discomfort or distraction, disturbance. Fight, we should fight. I have already done everything, and because of you know, my willpower, I fight.
Yes, Mary, and that is so inspirational.
Keep fighting is always I do, and I'm telling you, keep fighting, never give up. This is a message to all the women. And one day, what you want to achieve or you want to win, that will be given to you.
Mary, that is so inspirational hearing you say that. And somebody who has done it for so many years, I think it's wonderful. While there is also another category of people who are looking to, who have sent some questions. And mm-hmm. these are, so I have one question from Dr. Ramesh Srinivasan in Bangalore, one from Prashant Rabha in Gurgaon. And this is about young people. So young people, both boys and girls, many of them are in school, many of them are in college. Yeah. And now they are in this extraordinary situation. So some of them want to take up sports. Their parents are saying, no, why don't you study? Because for every successful Marie Kom in sports, there are many people who did not succeed. So what message would you like to give to the young boys and girls who are in school and college, and many of whom look up to you as an inspiration, as an icon? And so what would you want to share about that?
Yes, I just want to give some points, here in our country, yes, it's going up and down. We don't know what is going. And they must have some talent. They must have some talent. And even if you have talent also, if you don't do anything, only sleeping and watching or playing the phone, could not be in your life, you cannot win anything, or you cannot happen what you have already want to achieve. I mean, what you have dreamed could not be success.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There are many children are so talented. And that what we going to do is, including we should give some effort. Effort, Denise, study whoever in the college, on the school, study, focus. Focus in your study. I'm a sports person and I always focus in my training. Whether I'm doing better or I'm still a weak, not improving. So this is always I'm looking that. Yes, today I done strengthening. Yes, I leave a 40 weight bench press, push up and squats with weight and all. How many kg I have lived, how many squats with the weight I have done. All the time I have, written in my diary. So improving or not improving, this is the this is the basic. Study hard. I just want to tell those who are the our young students in the college, in the school, if you don't study, you will nothing. If you study hard, give effort, another extra effort, double, triple effort, that only you will achieve. Or you want to do whatever you want.
Right.
You will get whatever you want. This is the message to them. And whatever I was already mentioned before, sometimes it's going up and down. You already in the down. Nobody said that you will not be coming up. It's in your hand. It's in your hand. If you want to come up, you have to give some effort. That'd be extra. Then if you don't want to go, okay, no matter.
That's a great message, Mary, because the effort and the focus is really what you are telling us to do. So I think that's wonderful, Mary. Now, there are a lot of additional questions. There are some fun questions as well. There are some very fun questions. I want to read them out. And, I would like your response on that. So one of them is that at home, you have now 4 kids. So when your kids are fighting with each other, do you stop them or do you teach them to fight so that they can become good boxers?
Oh my God. Yeah. Thank you. This question is so interesting. Of course, might be as a boxer, they are asking me this question, right?
Yes.
And at home, actually my kids, I don't want to, motivate. I really don't want to motivate to them. While he has 4 boys and 1. 3 boys in one home. So difficult.
Yes.
They grew up together. Huh? Yeah, one is 16, one is 6, and one is very little boy.
Yes.
And that can, it won't fight. They will never fight. Mm-hmm. And they grew up together. It was so difficult. Every time is fight, 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 fight.
So do you teach them how to fight? Left side here, right side here?
No, no way. I always stop them. Please don't fight. I'm already tired. I have been fighting. I have been fighting 20 years. I'm tired. At home, please give me some, give me some rest.
Right.
That is all the time I am telling to them. And if they are a boxer, of course, I can also train them. No, come and fight. Yeah, come and have the match.
Right.
Open challenge. So they are not a boxer, but mostly we should. I think, in my opinion, is we should teach love initially, and maybe when they grow up, they will know that the humanity, how much we care, how much we love, how much we respect.
Yes. So
it's up to the parents only. If I say, then it's up to the parents from the beginning, from the when they are very little, or the childhood, from that only, if we teach some good tips, some good tips, or we guide them in a proper way, then I hope one day children also, they will become a good person.
Sure. So there is a variation of that question which has come in. That is that, what about your fights with your husband? Is it a verbal fight or is it a boxing match?
Only a verbal fight. No match at all. I'm scared, of course. He's not a boxer. He is a footballer now. He can use leg. I can use my hand. But he will use leg, then I could not able to compete to him. No, I have to say this. At home, of course, there is something, misunderstanding. All the husband and wife argument because of the misunderstanding only. So when we understand each other, then solve.
Yeah.
Yeah. No need to fight. Why they are fighting? Ek dusre larega, chot lagega. Kya matlab hai?
Right. Right. And somebody is sending me another question. Ki aap parliament mein jaate hain. So parliament mein, how is it different from a boxing ring? Is the fight of a different kind? How do you compare these two? Kaisa lagta hai ye dono ka difference?
Honestly, you know, this is not my profession.
Mm-hmm.
Not my profession. Like, you know, good cause, government. There are some good cause are always support to them and doing everything whatever they request me. Yes, good cause for the society, for the nation, I contribute.
Yeah.
And honestly, politics is, yeah, there is, I have already listening inside the parliament, like, you know, there is discussing going on, and there is some topics are through discussing is going, and they are not listening, it's other. There are so many arguments fighting government and opposition. Halla halla shor mazaya. I don't know something. I don't understand kya bol rahi hai banda, kya kar rahi hai, kya ho raha hai, samajh nahi aa raha hai. Are ye to mera ye to haath jo leta hai mera kaam nahi hai, ye to main kuch nahi kar payega, aise kabhi kabhi, you know, it's come in my mind. But sometimes it's so fun also, sometimes so I feel so good also. When I was, you know, abroad competing any competition, and all the parliamentarians, you know, before the session start, and they are giving a lot of love to me and giving a congratulations to me as well. So the big politician, government, other opposition, they have appreciating me. So I feel very good sometimes.
Wonderful. I have just a couple of, there are many questions, but maybe I will just ask one or two last questions. This one is from Akanksha Nehra, who is actually a nurse and is based out of Mumbai. Similar question is also there from Seema in Hyderabad. They want to ask you, what do you tell yourself when you wake up every morning?
Every morning, you know, I motivating myself.
Mm-hmm. What?
Here, even at home also, sometimes my kids are not well. And who will come and help us in this situation, in this pandemic? And even my parents, my husband parents could not able to come. There is an option. We have already option that they can fly also. But I'm telling that is, you know, I so risky. If there happen to while their journey or something, like, you know, it's anything happened to it affect to again my family only, no?
Yes.
So it's so risky what I'm doing all the time. Wake up, then be strong.
Be strong. That's what you're telling yourself every morning. Yeah.
Be strong and you can do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to defeat everything, then it's in my hand.
Right.
I do whatever. I woke up early morning and I make a breakfast to my children, preparing a breakfast to them, preparing for a lunch for them, preparing everything. You know, even there are so many housework as well. Jaru mara, poncha karna. I don't have any servant. This also a part of you know, my activities. That's also really helped in my profession.
Right. So telling yourself to be strong every morning, that is what you tell yourself.
Yes.
And on that, there is another question that many times, in spite of all the successes, there are some failures. So when you face failure, how do you tackle it? How do you react to failure?
Yes.
Or how do you overcome it? So that's the
Yeah, obviously, sometimes it's happened. Being a world champion and, you know, I cannot say that I will be all the time being a champion. You know, I will be all the time a champion.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's going down also. There is some, even I cannot able, I cannot understand what is my weakness. And later on, I realized that, you know, oh, this is my weakness. And I have to focus on that also, double focus, triple focus on that also.
Mm-hmm.
That is when I failure, like even when I lose some match in official this, you know, the Rio qualification.
Yes.
The Brazil one.
Yes.
I was so painful. I thought that time is come to retirement. Even my husband also. I think the time is come. You have to stop. Not to box. That is even in it's going in my mind. Even the same. Even my husband also telling me, you know, the same one. And it was so painful. Could not able to qualify. And I was taking some time to you know. I have how many to say?
Digest.
Mm-hmm. I have to you know, I have take 2-3 days to digest. Mm-hmm. I've already Olympian winning in the Olympic, and second time when I fail, you know, my the qualifying and all, it was so painful. But I could not able to share like, you know, how I was facing, cry, a lot of tears going. but only what I want to say is, this is so painful, and it just take time. Even I also doing, I take some time, like 2-3 days to digest. And lastly, what I was thinking is, no, this is not the end. You have still a chance, or you can still, you know, do better. Again, I already, what to say? It's come in my thought again. Why should I give up? Why should I give up? This is not only the last. This is not the end. So finally, and I digest, and okay, becoming more stronger. And yes, even I have already mentioned before also, I have given more time in my practice and, you know, more focus, more giving more effort. And even my family, also, they are full supporting me. There is no any restriction at all. And, you know, so the my behind my successful is obviously my husband, my parents, and all the countries supporting me, and also supporting me for the love, good messages, you know, good comments. So failures happen. I mean, I also want to say again after the smiling face at the end happen, but I don't give up. I'm again come back after I digest, and now again this time I able to qualify.
Yes, absolutely, Mary. So
I want to mention I will be the oldest athlete in the boxing in the Olympic boxing, I think, so far.
Absolutely, Mary. So I think the message you are giving is, first of all, don't digest, believe that this is not the end. Focus again, start practicing again, and have the well wishes of all the people who love you to support you. And I think that is what is going to happen in Tokyo now. Everybody is really going to be rooting for you for the gold medal, and I hope you will be
able to. I will try. Please do pray for me whenever you have a time. Not, I'm not saying every time pray for me. And I just want to say that, you know, we have our own God. And I'm belongs to Christian community. And even your love and the praying support also, it's very neat. It's going to help me. Without your support, without your prayers, I don't think I could able to, come back with the medal, or that will be difficult for me. That's why it's my appeal as well as request, love request. Support me, pray for me, and I will try my 110% to give.
We are very, very confident of that, Mary. So with that, I think we are almost at the end of time. I think one last request I have from people who are tuned in. Many people have said that you are an excellent singer. And
who said excellent singer? So,
people want you to sing a song for them. It could be in any language, Manipuri, Hindi, English, maybe your favorite, a few lines. That's what people are looking
for. Two lines only. Have to sing all the, until unless I'm not finished, then I'm not singing.
We are sitting here, absolutely.
Okay. Yes, I just want to I'm not that much good singer. Yes, I love to sing a song because music, singing, giving me that's also a lot of support. Whenever I was alone, alone means like going alone, not with my family, and I was keep listening music. Music is one of my best friend. So I just want to represent that in this pandemic situation, and one of my favorite song what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on? So I just want to dedicate to our heroes, our frontline workers.
Yeah.
I see you, Ma.
Mike, jaane se pehle.
I just want to play karaoke.
Sure.
Chai boli thi. Brew kyun?
Kyunki wo bhi to maine
air bhi par maine dance ki
thodi milegi.
जब चाय से काम ना चले पियो ब्रू कॉफी जो दे ज्यादा ताजगी
Yeah! destination. Thank you so much.
Wow. Absolutely amazing, Veri. Thank you so much. I think you have another profession available for you besides boxing, being a parliamentarian, and being a full-time mother.
Oh, thank you.
So, Mary, with that, we are very, very grateful to you for your time, our deepest gratitude, and thank you for being such a great inspiration to young people all over the world, to women all over the world, to men all over the world. I think the spirit of not giving up, the spirit of keeping to fight, the spirit of continuing and really rising up even when you have failed and then starting to walk again. Mary, we are very, very grateful to you for taking the time to talk to us and share your thoughts with us. We wish you all the very best in your endeavors in whichever field you take, and good health and happiness for you and your family. Thank you, Mary. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, dear.